was glad when they said unto me, we will go into the house of the Lord. Let us confess our sins against God and our neighbor.
Most merciful God, we confess that we have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by all that we have done and by all that we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We are truly sorry and humbly repent. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us and forgive us, that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways, to the glory of your name. Amen.
Almighty God, have mercy on us. Forgive us all our sins through our Lord Jesus Christ. Strengthen us in all goodness, and by the power of the Holy Spirit, keep us in eternal life. Amen. Amen. Lord, open our lips,
and our mouths shall proclaim your praise.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. Hallelujah.
Please be seated. We'll read responsibly for the Nite. Come, let us sing to the Lord.
Let us shout for joy to the rock of our salvation.
Let us come before his presence with thanksgiving.
And raise a loud shout to him with songs.
For the Lord is a great God.
And a great King of all gods.
In his hands are the caverns of the earth.
And the heights of the hills are his also.
The sea is his, for he made it.
And his sands are molded with thy hand.
Come, let us bow down and bend the knee.
And kneel before the Lord our Maker, for he is our God.
And we are the people of his pasture and the sheep of his hand.
Oh, that today you mark unto his voice. Hallelujah.
Be joyful in God, all you lands.
Sing the glory of his name. Sing the glory of his praise.
Say to God, how awesome are your deeds.
Because of your great strength, your enemies cringe before you.
All the earth bows down before you.
Sing to you, sing out your name.
Come now and see the works of God.
How wonderful he is in his doing for all people.
He turned the sea into dry land, so that they went through the water on foot.
And there we rejoice in him.
In his might, he rules forever. His eyes keep watch over the nations.
Let no rebel rise up against him.
Bless our God, you peoples.
May the voice of his praise to the earth.
Who holds our souls in life.
And will not allow our feet to slip.
For you, O God, have proved us.
You have tried us just as silver is tried.
You brought us into the snare.
You laid many burdens upon our backs.
You let enemies ride over our heads. We went through fire and water.
But you brought us out into a place of refreshment.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
Our first reading is from Jeremiah. These are the words of the letter that the prophet Jeremiah sent to Jerusalem to the remaining elders among the exiles, and to the priests, the prophets, and all the people whom Nebuchadnezzar had taken into exile from Jerusalem to Babylon. Thus says the Lord of hosts, the God of Israel, to all the exiles whom I have sent into exile from Jerusalem to Babylon, build houses and live in them. Plant gardens and eat what they produce. Take wives and have sons and daughters. Take wives for your sons and give your daughters in marriage, that they may bear sons and daughters. Multiply there and do not decrease. But seek the welfare of the city where I have sent you into exile, and pray to the Lord on its behalf, for in its welfare you will find your welfare. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our second reading is from 2 Timothy. Remember Jesus Christ, raised from the dead, a descendant of David. That is my gospel, for which I suffer hardship, even to the point of being chained like a criminal. But the word of God is not chained. Therefore I endure everything for the sake of the elect, so that they may also obtain the salvation that is in Christ Jesus with eternal glory. The saying is sure. If we have died with him, we will also live with him. If we endure, we will also reign with him. If we deny him, he will deny us. If we are faithless, he remains faithful, for he cannot deny himself. Remind them of this, and warn them before God that they are to avoid wrangling over words, which does no good, but only ruins those who are listening. Do your best to present yourself to God as one approved by him, a worker who has no need to be ashamed, rightly explaining the word of truth, the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Let us worship God with words of Magnificat. My soul proclaims the greatness of the Lord. My spirit rejoices in God my Savior.
For he has looked with favor on his lowly servant.
From this day all generations will call me blessed.
The Almighty has done great things for me, and how holy is his name.
He has mercy on those who fear him.
In every generation.
He has shown the strength of his arm.
He has scattered the proud and the conceited.
He has cast down the mighty from their thrones.
And has lifted up the lowly.
He has filled the hungry with good things.
And the rich he has sent away empty.
He has come to the help of his servant Israel.
For he has remembered his promise of mercy.
The promise he made to our fathers.
To Abraham and his children forever.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
Please stand for the Gospel. A reading from the Gospel according to Luke. On the way to Jerusalem, Jesus was going through the region between Samaria and Galilee. As he entered the village, 10 lepers approached him, keeping their distance. They called out, saying, "Jesus, Master, have mercy on us." When he saw them, he said to them, "Go and show yourselves to the priests." And as they went, they were made clean. Then one of them, when he saw that he was healed, turned back, praising God with a loud voice. He prostrated himself at Jesus' feet and thanked him. And he was a Samaritan. Then Jesus asked, "Were not 10 made clean? But the other 9, where are they?" Was none of them found to return and give praise to God except this foreigner? Then he said to him, "Get up and go on your way. Your faith has made you well." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Please be seated. This is a small passage of Scripture, but it's a very rich one. We see here Jesus on a journey, headed south from Galilee toward Jerusalem. And to get there, he has to pass through a region that is between Samaria and Galilee. And because, of course, at this time everyone traveled on foot, it's likely that he will encounter many other travelers along the way. So as he comes close to this village, he's immediately approached by 10 lepers. Now, remember, at this time, leprosy was more than just a disease. It brought a sentence of exclusion from the community. Lepers were forced to leave their homes and their families and live apart from everyone else. If you had leprosy at this time, you you bore a great social stigma, and you were required to inform everyone who crossed your path loudly and clearly by saying, "Unclean, unclean," so they would know not to come too close to you. So it's safe to assume, then, that this interaction between Jesus and the lepers takes place outside of the village, because the lepers wouldn't be allowed in the village. But you know, word has clearly traveled about this man, Jesus, and his ability to heal, because immediately the lepers, while keeping their distance, appeal to Jesus, "Have mercy on us," they plead. Imagine being plagued by this kind of horrible skin disease and being an outcast from everyone you know and love. But now, maybe, just maybe, there's a chance that this unusual man, the one who is the subject of these stories and rumors, the one who is said to have healed the sick, maybe he's the one who can heal you, bring you relief from your suffering. Well, wouldn't we all be asking in that situation, "Jesus, please have mercy on me"? And Jesus, the great physician, he does have mercy. His response, "Go and show yourselves to the priests," doesn't sound terribly compassionate on the surface. But in Jewish law at that time, only the priests could pronounce a leper as being clean. So Jesus was saying, "Yes, yes, I've healed you, but now follow the law and go to the priests so that they can readmit you to your community." And off they go. Imagine their conversation as they turn to each other and see that their sores have disappeared. Imagine witnessing the healing of your companions and hearing them say, "Yeah, your sores are gone too." Just think about the joy and the wonder they must have felt in that circumstance. But then, one of the ten, turns back. And he's a Samaritan, a member of the lower class that the Jewish community despised and disparaged. Think of the very last person that we privileged and polite folks would expect in our world to show good manners, and that would be the Samaritan. And yet, he is the one of the ten who returns to express thanks. He prostrates himself at Jesus' feet, the scripture tells us, praising God with a loud voice. In what I imagine to be a rather wry voice, Jesus responds to him, "Were not ten made clean? The other nine, where are they? Get up and go on your way. Your faith has made you well." Gratitude, giving thanks. It's easy to forget, isn't it, when our vision is clouded by the things that aren't going right in our estimation. The disappointments we have, the failures, the things that leave us sad or lonely or desolate. COVID, when it hits. Sometimes it's hard to notice our multitude of blessings when we're so distracted by the imperfect in our lives. But our God knows what scientists are now verifying in their research, that gratitude is good for us. Showing gratitude is good for our mental, emotional, and social well-being. Grateful people report higher levels of satisfaction in life. They have more optimism, more vitality, and lower levels of depression and stress. There's some suggestion in the research that gratitude might even be associated with better physical health. And the people who benefit from gratitude, they're not the pie in the sky, nothing can bring me down lightweights. They know that life has challenges and burdens, but according to the research, people who make gratitude a habit, who cultivate a practice of being grateful, seem to lead happier and healthier lives. Something I think we reminds us that gratitude was and is a virtue in Judaism. The prayers Jesus and other Jews prayed were full of praise and gratitude to God, even though, as we know, the Jews had suffered mightily throughout their history. The expectations for the Samaritan, however, would have been low at best. And yet, here he is, the one we might equate with a migrant, a foreigner, a misfit, someone despised for being different. He is the one from the group who pleases Jesus with his response. And he is the one who is made well, as Jesus says. Well, even beyond his physical healing. What can we take from this to apply to our lives today and tomorrow and every day? I hope that you will never be a social outcast like these lepers were. I hope you'll never experience a disease or a condition or a lifestyle that makes you an outsider. But I know that you, like all of us, will face burdens and fears and hard times in your lives. I also know that God will hear our pleas, relieve our suffering, will help us resolve our problems, and will continue to bless us richly in a myriad of ways. When we experience healing, when our hope is restored, when we see the light at the end of a very hard road, when we're the recipients of kindness and grace, I hope we'll choose to be like that Samaritan, the one who was made well, the one who celebrated, but also remembered from whence his blessings came. Gratitude is good for us. This week, I challenge you and myself to think of ways to be more grateful. Tell someone you appreciate what they do. Compliment the chef, even if it's your partner. Give thanks for the small things, the things that seem mundane, even though we know they matter. Thank a teacher, or a soldier, or a public safety worker, or even a clergy person who's feeling miserable with COVID. Do like the person did at McDonald's this morning when I stopped to get a Diet Coke, and pay the bill for the person behind you. Make a list of some of the good things in your life, and then spend time in prayer, thanking God for those things. God knows that gratitude is good for us. Let's make a practice of gratitude to God and to all those who matter in our lives. That practice might just make us well, too. Please stand for the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, His only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He ascended to the dead.
We put our trust in you.
In you, Lord, is our hope.
And we shall lay our hope in vain.
Lord, we pray that your grace may always precede and follow us, that we may continually be given to good works through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
O God, you make us glad with the weekly remembrance of the glorious resurrection of your Son, our Lord. Give us this day such blessing through our worship of you, that the week to come may be spent in your favor, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Almighty and everlasting God, by whose Spirit the whole body of your faithful people is governed and sanctified, receive our supplications and prayers which we offer before you for all members of your holy church, that in their vocation and ministry they may truly and devoutly serve you through our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Join me now in the general thanksgiving.
Almighty God, Father of all mercies, we, your unworthy servants, give you humble thanks for all your goodness and loving kindness to us and to all whom you have made. We bless you for our creation, preservation, and all the blessings of this life, but above all for your immeasurable
have given us grace at this time with one accord to make our common supplication to you. And you have promised through your well-beloved Son that when two or three are gathered together in his name, you will be in the midst of them. Fulfill now, O Lord, our desires and petitions as may be best for us, granting us in this world knowledge of your truth, and in the age to come, life everlasting.
Amen.
Let us bless the Lord.
Thanks be to God.